This is a tutorial on Anki. Specifically, I'm going to cover how to install Anki, how to make new cards, and then how to download other people's decks. These are pretty much the two main things you're going to be doing with Anki. There's a lot of add-ons and additional features, but keep this simple and just cover the basics. So first things you're going to want to do is Google Anki download, and should be the first link, and then click download, and then follow the steps and install. And after it's all installed and you open it up, it will look similar to this. I have a dark background, but it's pretty similar. Okay, so before we get into making cards, there is one add-on that is absolutely essential that you use. It is a game changer. So I'm going to show you how to install that. So you come up here to Tools, Add-ons, Browse and Install, Browse, and then it is Image Occlusion Enhanced. Scroll down to here, copy this code, paste it in the code box, hit OK. I already have it, so I'm not gonna hit OK. And it will download it and install it in Anki. And then you will have to close out and open Anki back up, and it will be installed. So once you have that installed, here is how you make cards. So first of all, down here at the bottom, you can create decks to organize your cards. So I'll just call this demo. Maybe this will be called Renal. I make a deck like for each class usually. So click on a deck and hit add card. Now, right here, it says what type of flashcard and then what deck it's going to be placed into. Now, the basic card is going to be your front and your back. But this is not a very efficient way to make cards. So I highly recommend using close. So you come down, you choose close. And what this does is it allows you to block out one word or multiple words in a sentence. You can use this button here to do it, or you can use the shortcut Command-Shift-C. Now what that'll look like is, let's close out of this, and we're back at the demo deck. Let's go back. This is the main menu. There's one new card, the one we just made. Click on it. Now, before we hit add, but now we're going to hit study to see. So you can see that one word is blanked out. And if you hit show answer, we see it. And then if you didn't get the card right, you hit again. If you got it right, you hit good. And you're going to see it in 10 minutes. If you get it right twice, it will be pushed till tomorrow. If you get it right tomorrow, it'll be pushed out 3 or 4 days. If you get it right then, et cetera, et cetera. So that's what this does, is the cards that you're consistently getting right, you see less and less often. The ones you get wrong, you start seeing more and more. It's a very efficient way to study. Okay, so let's go back to demo, and let's add. Now, let's do so we just did a close card. Let's do a image occlusion card. So these are best for pictures. So I'm gonna find a picture online of the kidney. This one looks decent. It's kind of small, but it'll work. So what I do is Command Control Shift 4, and I can take a screen capture. Now what that did is, because I hit Command Control Shift 4, it took that screenshot and it put it in my clipboard. So I could paste that right now in like a Word document, or I could even paste it in here and make like a close card. But what I want to do for image occlusion is click on this button here, add image occlusion, and it opens up the image occlusion editor. And it takes a second for everything to resize. And then I can just blank out structures and make each one of these a card. So I've got five boxes, and if I hit, I just hit Command Return, and it, see, it created five cards. So now let's go take a look at what those look like. So we're back in the demo deck study. See, now I can just go through each card. So the image occlusion is extremely efficient, especially with pictures. So for like anatomy and diagrams, it's an excellent way to learn. Okay, so those are like the two, 95% of the cards I make are either close or image occlusion. Those are the most useful features. Now let's cover how to download pre-made decks. So there is a great website called Anki. I think it's called Anki Medical School. Medschoolanki.com. And this site basically just breaks down all of the different pre-made Anki decks for medical school. And you can see here, you want to choose one of these and one of these and one of these. And that's what I did. I'm using Lightyear, Pepper, and some other decks. But anyways, so you can download them here, or you can just search online like Anki decks. Let's see what happens. And even Anki Web, you can upload your decks to share with people. And you can search here for like USMLE and find stuff. Or if you want to do something outside of medical school, you can even like learn another language and stuff like that. So let's see. So this is the most popular USMLE deck. So there's a ton of stuff here. You can even export your own decks and share them with your friends. There's a lot of stuff you can do. So let's see. I want to download like a small... This I'm downloading this deck because it only has 29 cards, so it should be pretty small. So download it, and then once it's downloaded, click on it. It'll import the cards. Oh, here's another thing. The default settings in Anki only have you do 20 new cards per day, but you're probably going to want to do more than that. So I recommend coming to options. And then here, where it says new cards per day, I just max it out and just say 99999. And then under the reviews tab, max reviews per day is set to 200. I also max this out because like the day before a test, I might end up doing well over 1,000 cards. So now you can see all 58 cards in this deck are available. So you just click on them and there you go. So those are the basics of Anki.